Hi Richard, here's another attempt. I want to make set up the full project with all the songs included, but I will only engrave the first piece. So, but it will give you an idea of how to prepare a full project. So let's start with solo instrument guitar, new from template. And I'm using the built-in microphone from the computer right now, not a separate microphone. So probably the sound is a little bit acoustic, like a nice room reverb, maybe. So this is flow one, and the setup we do all, the first thing you do when you start a new project is you go to setup after choosing the instrument. And from here you can add more instruments if you want. But we don't need it right now, so. I can delete this one. Delete players, yes. So I will only do what's really necessary for this project, because there's so much otherwise that I want to explain, and it's too much, I think. So guitar, and then we go to setup, layout options to choose the correct page size, letter. Apply. And you can choose for the layouts separately, as you can see. But this will be a full score. In this case, I just choose the full score. And you can also work on pieces separately here. But you choose the full score in this case. So I'm now going to rename this song. My cold is not disappearing, very annoying. Already for 3 weeks. So, we don't need this right now. And like I did the last time, let's make the second one. See. So, what I'm doing now is I'm going to add all the different songs, song titles, every time by adding a new flow. There's plus flow. And a flow is the same as a piece in a collection. So there can be different movements in a sonata or a symphony or songs in an album, like in this case. So I'm going to add all the different songs now using the flow option here. Okay, so I added all the other pieces. So there's 11 songs in total, 11 parts in social total. And after having done this, I'm going to file project info. And here you can find, this is a place where you can put information on all the different parts. So also the project itself. So let's give it a title. Missa para funerals. And does it need a subtitle? Well, maybe not. Composer Anthony Timuran. And from here you can also this time you can just do a copy and paste, but normally you can also, instead of, if you would have filled in everything here, you can just say, okay, copy from here, copy from one piece, one song to another. So you don't have to fill in everything all the time. But in this case, it's only a single composer name, I think I have to fill in. Yeah, not even a copyright, no. So let's do this quickly. So now what we have here is like I said before, you have to be very aware which mode you are. For example, if you're in setup mode, and even with the little hand selector, you cannot pull the sheets, the pages. So that's only possible in engrave mode and in write mode. So that took me a while to figure out. And this one is for selecting. So you cannot pull pages either, drag pages. So you really have to be in this mode to do that. can also work in Galley View, but I'm not such a fan of this, so I always work in, it's like panorama view in Sibelius, but I would like to work in page view. So you see everything is set up now, and every piece starts on a new page. Now, in the example here, it's not really the way we want it, so all these musical flows start, you can decide if they start on a new page or it continues on the same page. So in this case we want to have it continue, and if I have am correct, you have to go to setup layout options to where you can put this here. Yeah, flows. These are the flows. New flows always start on a new page or allow on existing page. So we use this in this case. So now everything starts on the same page, as you can see, and it looks really weird right now, but the moment you fill it in, everything will be correct. And let's start with the first one. So the first one, I'm zooming in and out with the command key command and then scroll on the mouse. So that's really handy. It's a little bit same as in Sibelius. I'm not sure anymore if I placed this, put this, if it adjusted the key commands, where you can adjust everything with the key commands and also zoom in, zoom out. So I probably adjusted the key commands, but that's something you have to figure out what's the easiest for you to use. So let's see. Let's start with the first one. First, you have to be in write mode to enter music, and you can do it by double click with the mouse or with selecting the place where you want to start and hit the enter key. And then you see these two little things, and these are the, this is the musical grid, so 8 notes, 16 notes, and with this and the mouse and the arrow keys on the keyboard, you can go from one to the next. And the musical grid can be set here. I also like to set it on the 16th, which is the finest you can do here. So you have a lot of precise possibility. So the first thing we have to do is put the time signature, and you can do it by shift M, shift meter. Or you can go to here, and at some point, actually, I like to do this more than the shift M, because it goes faster, to be honest, even when the other thing looks much nicer. Okay, that's the first one, and then the key signature is A major. 3 sharps, and there you go. And with this one you can close or open the panels. It's in all the sides. The inspector below here. You can, even here, you can close this one. So let's start with the first, entering the note for the first piece. Maybe make this a little bit bigger, if possible. Yes, there you go. So in fact we have set up the whole project now, and the only thing we need to do for all the pieces is entering the music. Now let's have a look at print for a moment. I made a big mistake that I wanted to print and I could not select anything from here, so I thought that's a bug. But no, when you print stuff you have to select from here. You can make a lot of different personal layouts, and you can see all the instruments separately, or you can see the full score. So in this case it's not so much different to see, but for example here you see all the different parts still when you choose the solo instrument, one of the parts. So this is a part selection and this is a full score selection. So but let's go to the full score. I know you see all the pieces on the same page as much as possible. So let's start the first one. I double click in the bar where to start, and I go to beat 4. And now I choose on the keyboard on the upper row, number row, I choose the value of the notes. You can also choose it from here, but I like to use the keyboard keys. So 6, I always have my middle finger on the 6, which is a quarter note value, and then automatically going down, the 5 is the 8th note, the going down is the 16th note, and then the 7 is the quarter note. You can also see the shortcut on the popover right now. And half note is the 7th, and 8 is the quarter note. So here's my MIDI keyboard, of my normal keyboard, and as you can see, I have all different kind of information. This is for Sibelius, actually. And so, but for Dorico, for the note values, you use the 6th. I have the finger, my finger always on the 6th for the quarter note, and then this is 8th note, 16th note, 32, and up, this is half note, this is a whole note, alla breve, I think this one, and to put the rhythmical dot, I use this one. So I'm always like this with my hand, ready to go here, and the T you use to tie notes together, so it's nice close also, and the S you use to put a slur over notes, so it's pretty easy actually. So let's start with the 8th note. And let's enter the notes on the, on the MIDI keyboard. Oh wait, it's the guitar. It automatically goes one octave different. I adjusted my MIDI keyboard right now, so notated one octave lower. So to enter a dot, you can either click this one here, or you can click the period on the keyboard. So the next note will be. And then this happens because Dorico decides, okay, I want to have this kind of notation. If you don't want that, you can undo it. Undo is also Alt Z, like in Sibelius. You can select this one for duration, and then everything will be noted the way you really want it, the way you're choosing values. So let's do this again. And I will just enter all the notes. So the shortcuts, you really have to, the keyboard shortcuts, you have to memorize them, or just write them down on your in your keyboard, like just like you would do with Finale or Sibelius. So let's, so now it's just a matter of entering the notes, and I think for this we can just quickly fast forward. One thing I really like to do when I engrave from a music example, like in this example, I like to make the layout the same as it is here, so it's easy to follow where you are in the score. So in this case I'm going to put here's not really necessary right now, but when you put the lyrics, it's going to push the next system. So here I'm going to put a system break. System breaks, breaks and page breaks, so you're going to place in engrave mode. And in this mode, you cannot do anything with the notes. You cannot delete them, you cannot change, you cannot enter note. This is pure only for this, for the layout. So you select bar line and you put a system break. You see here, system break. And let's see, the next one will be on bar 12. So we put them here. System break. Then on bar 18. Would be nice to see all the bar numbers. So we go to bar numbers in page view. So we can see all the bar numbers. Place another system break. And we need some more bars. 26 bars for this piece, so we have to add 6 more bars. You can do that by selecting the last or just anywhere, actually, in this case, doesn't matter, there's no music at the end. and just add bars by Shift B. Oh, you see, it's not possible. You can only work on the layout. So you have to go back to right and add Shift B. And then plus how many bars? 6, I think we said. 7, we can do. And there you go. 4, 5, 6. Yes, that's correct. You can also add bars by this option here. Bars and bar lines. And you can put the amount of bars here. And then where do you want a bar to be added? And then just click insert bars. But we did it already, so. So let's go back to engrave to adjust layout. 12 and then a system break on page 8 and bar 18. It's already there. And the last one is 24. Let me make a system break. And now in this case, because the song, the next song starts on a new page, I want to imitate this. Let's see. There you go. Yes. And it starts on, yeah, in this case it doesn't work like this. It's 27, it's one too much. So we can also delete bars just by again selecting anywhere at the end and Shift B. Again in write mode, Shift B and then minus one, which doesn't work. It should work. Okay, it doesn't work. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. I'm not sure what it depends on. But there is another trick for do it later. Let Dorica do this. Delete bars that you don't want. So let's continue in. let's continue with the note input. Okay, I entered all the notes now, and I don't really want to see this right now, these things, so I'm going to view send post and uncheck system breaks to make the image a little bit clearer, the page. And now I want to get rid of this last bar. So I entered all the notes, bar 26, and I go to right trim flow, and Dorico takes it away. So the next thing I want to do is see, I have to enter this repeat bar here, that is bar 17, so I select this place here, it's just the bar itself or something in the bar, the position in the bar, and I go to this one, repeat structures. And let's see, I want to have I want to have, like here, a tree, number three. So let's see, how do we do this? Go to properties. And there's so many things to here, as you can see. To be honest, I'm not sure how to do this. So what did I do? I selected, I'm discovering things while I work with the program as well. So on I have three, let's see number of times played. So we can turn this off maybe. 1, 2, 3. Let's see what happens. There's a lot you can adjust here. Maybe I have to use this instead. Let's try this again. So you would expect, oh no, this is just for extra. So from here, I can maybe in engrave mode, number of endings, segment duration, End of line, open short. So, to be honest, I have no idea right now how to do this. You can add as many iterations as you want, but to emulate exactly what's on the page here, I have no idea. So we just leave it like this, and we I have no idea. I have asked this question on the Durka forum just now to see how I can emulate this part. For now, let's do it like, it's not possible to make it even smaller. No. Okay, for now, let's leave it like this. I'm sure there must be a way to do that. So let's continue with the engraving. Let's see, what else do I need to do here? Okay, I can put the metronome number here, and we do this by selecting where we want the metronome to start, and then shift T tempo, and then use the number keyboard on the top view keyboard for the quarter note. It's a 6, the same as you use when you enter the notes, equal sign, and then 80. And there you go. If you would like to add text to this, have it selected and then open the inspector in write mode. And you can add, for example, normally something like that. And then check text show. There you go. You can also turn off different parts. You can keep it parenthesized. Yeah. There's a lot of options here. Approximate, you can add. But for now, let's see. A metronome sized. Metronome mark shown. Yes, there you go. Okay, and then we continue with the lyrics. Now, to enter lyrics, select where you want the lyric to start, and then use Shift L for lyric to start with the lyrics. Now, the nice thing is here, you have the arrow up and down key, you can choose which lyric line you want to start. So as you can see, a lot of lyrics, I have no idea how many. A lot of lyric lines, so verses. Let's go back to one. So this is for voice one, and this is voice one. You can actually see this voice one as you click on it, as if you would start entering notes again. You see the note with the stem up, and it means it is voice one. Now, if you want to enter, for example, a voice two, you would hit normally the V on your keyboard, but now nothing happens, because there is only one voice. To add another voice, use Shift V, and now you see you have a plus, meaning there's a new voice with the stem down. Wait, this was not so. So now if you start double click, you can click the V, type V, oh, I undid it. Now you can exchange between two voices. So if I would enter again, and now hit V. This is really weird, right? Maybe, oh, I didn't enter anything yet. So if I would enter a note now, for example, this is the second voice. So now if I start, I toggle with the V. I can choose between one first voice, second voice. You can also add voices from here. Create voice. This is Shift V, what I did just now to create the second voice, or go to next voice. But there are only two voices right now. So, but in this case, we don't really need this. But if you would start with lyrics, you can select the note where you want to start, and then shift L for lyrics, and then, for example, first voice one, and then again, let's do it again, and now with the arrow down key, go to the second voice, so this voice, and then this will be voice two. So it's pretty nice. Now, if you would go to open the inspector, you get even more options. For example, you can choose if it is a chorus voice, it's italic, or if it will be a translation, it's going to be in a different position also. You can align the lyrics left, right, etc. We have a lot of extra options here, italic. But let's keep it the way it is. Which is really nice, a lot of options. So let's delete them because we don't really need them. And now let's add the lyrics for this piece. So shift L, and we just start typing. Let's type like as a normal word processor. Senor, and just go to the next with the space bar, and if you want to hibernate, just use the little star, and there you have the little hibernation. So it's that easy. So I'm going to fill in the rest of the text now, and see you back in a moment. So I finished all the text, and now let's see. The only thing left, I believe, are the chords. Well, the chord names are no problem, but the guitar diagrams, it's not possible in Durka right now. So let's enter first the chords names, and I believe this is done by CQ. Yes, this is this one, chord names, CQ, shift Q. So just hit them on the keyboard, on the MIDI keyboard. Yes, and I can go to the next part with the arrow keys backwards, according to the musical grid, rhythmical grid. Let's see if it works like this. Yes. You can also type them just like a normal web processor. So see, next one I can type D. I can use the shift, the arrow keys or the space bar to move to the next. Probably beat or musical grid, it depends what you have set here. You can make it a little bit shorter. So D and then select and then shift Q or this one. And then you can type in the name, B minor, I think, probably. Yeah. Yeah, B minor. I will use the MIDI keyboard now. It's not great. Select this one, say Q, and then A, T, B, etc., etc. Okay, I added all the chord names, and now to put really the guitar symbols, which is not possible right now, we should, we could use them as graphics, as you suggested. So for this we go to engrave mode and turn on frames. So now we see really, now we can influence all the different frames on the score. If you turn it off, you cannot select them. So everything is saved, you can do only other stuff. Turn on the frames, then graphic frames, set graphic frames. And yes, as I said before, these frames that you can draw now, they are not connected to the nodes themselves. That's the problem. You can move them around, like probably every layout kind of program. So it's best to add them at the end when you're really sure, okay, this is how my score is going to look like. But in this case, let's make them. So you put in, you draw a frame, you double click inside the frame, and then you edit. Oh, we need a little picture for this. Let's make a little screenshot here. This will be not high quality, that's for sure. And where do I go from here? Let's stop. And this one. So there you have it. And yeah, it's not really the best quality. Let's see how it looks like in write mode. So here you have it. And print mode. It's not really a great image. I don't think you should really use these kind of things, as long as Dorico cannot handle it himself. But the possibility is there. So this is how you would do this. So, and what I like to do mostly is, after having engraved the piece, take away all the the breaks. So for this you have to see them first. So you go to view signposts, turn on the views for the breaks. Then I do select all in write mode, select all, and then edit, filter, and all breaks. And then I hit the delete key. So now Dorico, this is on. His own layout editing. So this is the whole piece, and as you can see, the second part starts here. Second, third, and so this is the fourth already. So, well, in this case, the second part. No, wait, the second part starts on a new page, and I believe you can even layout option tell to work. No, you cannot. It's yes or no with the flows where they have to start on a new page. But let's make them start on a new page for now. So now you can see it really senior temp yet be that start on a new page. So this is how you do it. I hope this helps a little bit, Richard. And I hope I find out how to fix this one here.